Hey, hey, what's up, fellow collectors, guys, and girls from around the world? It's Command35 back here again, coming at you with another video. Today, we're going to be going through some Star Wars collectibles-related news. And, yeah, we got a bunch of new stuff just came in, info-wise, data, whatever you want to call it as. Big thanks to JediTempleArchives.com. They're the major source that I've been getting a lot of this information from, and I'm very grateful for it. Without a lot of these places out there, we wouldn't be able to find out this information so quickly. And what I do is I look through that, and then I give my opinions on it on here, and just in case people might not see their sites, you guys see it here too. So, yeah, thanks to them again. And today we're going to be talking about some Star Wars Episode 7 toys. They unofficially released a bunch of stuff talking about all the different figures coming out, the vehicles and everything, all that great stuff. We even got some photos that appears to be preparation for the Star Wars Episode 7 toy line released stores, aka Force Friday. And it comes from this place called Meijer's. Never heard of them, don't really care. All that matters to me is this Star Wars toy majumbo. And what we have here, it's price tags, basically what it is. And, you know, the first one here, like, we got the Millennium Falcon, right? The 3¾-inch Falcon for $140. Now, we had a 2008 Falcon released back, and that one was much, much more expensive. And I'm not sure. This is an Episode 7 Falcon representation, so I'm not sure how the scaling is going to be. Is it going to be much smaller? And also it's going to be like new features added since it's a new film. The vehicle aged over time, so we can't really be too sure about that, but the price sounds fair. Next up, we got this kind of wonky thing, a Star Wars Jedi Master Yoda. The price tag says for $180. What is it, a fucking statue? I don't know. No comment really on that except for what the fuck. This one's like one of the most intriguing things I've seen, and a lot of people were buzzing about this. This is how I kind of became aware of all this. The Star Wars Episode 7 First Order Star Wars Star Destroyer playset. Now it's $40. I'm like, it's got to be 3¾-inch, because if it was a 6-inch playset, that would not work for $40. They would not charge that cheaply. So it's obviously a 3¾-inch set. Now, a lot of people were buzzing around saying, like, you know, what if they did, like, modular play sets, and you know, like, they've done before in the past, and then, or... The fact that they're bringing back play sets in the first place is very phenomenal. This is going to be the First Order Star Destroyer. That's interesting. I wonder where they're going to go with it. Are they going to do the hangar? Are they going to do the bridge? Are they going to make more? The thing I'm guessing is it's if these toys sell well, which I think Disney assumes that they will, but Hasbro's not really sure. I don't know. I don't think if it does sell well, they will make more playsets. But I am fascinated by the idea of playsets. Even though I don't play with toys, it would be a great collectible to have in my collection. Like, we got more images right here. We got a Star Wars 3¾-inch Class 1 vehicle for $20. That could either be like a deluxe pack, or it's like that Mission Series crap that they did a while back. Those vehicles are like much smaller scale, and I do not like those at all. I hate those with a passion. Next up, we got the standard 3¾-inch figures, something called Jungle Space, for $8. Very cheap. I'm kind of suspicious on that. I doubt that will be the retail price in normal stores, besides Meijer's, whatever you call that, pronounce it wise, whatever. And Jungle Space, my guess on that, because they also have another thing over here, which I came aware of today, They have an armored figures, that's all it says, 3¾-inch. And they also have snow and desert. So, what is this? Are they introducing interchangeable armor for their figures now? Are they, is that like the new trend of today, or... That would be kind of cool. Like, think of that. Like, you get two figures in one. And if it was $8, that would be phenomenal. That's like the old days. They used to sell figures that cheap. They don't do that no more. They also have the 6-inch scale TIE Fighter on the list, priced at $170. Not bad. And they have something else called the Special TIE Fighter for Episode 7, which is $40. I'm going to guess that's a 3¾-inch scale version. Moving on, remember when we talked about the Class 1 vehicles? Well, the new information we got today from Jedi Temple Archives, thankfully very much, it goes into more elaboration on the vehicles. Now, there's also a Class 1, 1.5, I guess you want to call it, which comes with a figure, and the Class 1 regular comes with no figure. Then they also have a Class 2 that comes with a figure and one without a figure. And finally, they have a Class 3 vehicle, which goes for $50, the most expensive out of all the vehicles that will be coming out. I'm curious to see which ones they will be. They will definitely have to be, these are for the 3 3/4 inch figures, but I mean, like, they'd have to be some, this one, the $50 one, will have to be good quality if they're charging it for like a standard vehicle, but it's Class 3. Like, it's, I mean, I'm assuming that would suggest better, higher quality. We'll have to wait and see though. A few more things, you know, the standard 6-inch figure assortment, they're still $20 a piece, good, no rise in the price. A 2-pack will be $15 according to this, and then the armored figures, like I mentioned before, which I believe might be interchangeable type thing, it's $13. I'm not sure why that's lower. Is it a 2-pack? Is it just one figure, like a bigger type 3 3/4 inch figure? That's what it says, 3 3/4 inch figure. Same for the 2-packs, 3 3/4 inch. And there's just a bunch of other random things, like we got the Captain Phasma for $15, like the 12-inch plastic piece of crap thing. We got Funko Pop figures for $10. And also, what was it? One last stupid thing I noticed, a Mission Series figure. Those are going up to $13. What the fuck is that? Yeah, so some of this information is accurate, I feel like, and some might be a little funky, little wonky-ish. And the final thing I wanted to talk about real quick, like, is this the new themed packaging we have for the Star Wars figures for Episode 7. It's Kylo Ren with this red-type Sith evil theme going on to it, and it just looks Star Warsy, sexy-ish, badass, and I'm very pleased how it looks, and yeah, I think it'll entice me to buy more figures for sure. So yeah, fellow collectors, guys and girls from around the world, let me know what you feel about all this down below. Vent your emotions, I want to hear it. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and subscribe for more Star Wars collectibles related news. Thank you guys so much for watching, keep the peace and love going, and may the Force be with you. Bye-bye.